I just got Canva Pro, the trial version for 30 days. I'm gonna do another level up design with this one right here. I'm gonna try and make it better, make it fit the space, and make it more of a vintage style. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I often get DMs in Instagram asking me for help on looking at people's shops and their designs and wondering what they can do to improve their t-shirts. So in this video, I'm taking one from my DMs recently. They've been doing a lot of t-shirt designs on Redbubble, and I'm gonna update this design right here. I'm gonna still use the same phrase, but I'm gonna show you what I would do with that phrase and why I make the decisions that I'm doing and how to do it all. And I'm gonna do it all in Canva. I'm gonna use Canva Pro, but a lot of the things I'm gonna be using are for Canva Free, but you'll see some of the different things that I like about Canva Pro in it too. So let's get into Canva right now. So here I am on Canva, canva.com, and you can see I have Pro now. It doesn't say Free, but I'm gonna just use a lot of the free stuff anyway. The first thing I'm gonna do is custom size, and I'm gonna do 4,500 by 5,400. It saved that for me. The first thing we're gonna do is just type the text so we have it here. I'm gonna go to text, and I'll just use headline. You can also type in T right here. And the phrase that we're looking for is, I have, so, I'm gonna do this in chunks. So I have so mushroom, there's the pun, in my heart. For you. So that's the phrase that shirt had. You know, we're gonna do a lot better than just this right here. So the first thing I'm gonna do is look for mushrooms. So when I look for mushrooms, when I think of mushrooms, I'm thinking of vintage mushrooms. And let's just look here in elements. I'm gonna type in mushroom. Boom. And then graphics. Boom. And one thing for, I don't know why they don't do this in the free version, but you can do free right here. I wish they did this in the free version that you can click on free, but only in the pro version will you see pro and free, which is weird because in free version, I actually want the free stuff. And then I want it static. I don't want it animated. And let's do that. So what I'm looking for is a vintage mushroom, but I also want other things in there besides the mushroom. So I'm going to look for like something with a flower or some other things in there, some other elements, so I can kind of put them all together because I don't want just the mushroom. I want to do other things with it. So let's scroll down here and see what I can find. And it's going to be trial and error. So if I like a mushroom, let's see, I'll try this one. And then magic recommendations. Are there flowers I can use in here? You know, probably not. So I'm going to take this mushroom out and go back here and then keep looking. So it may take me a little while. I'm going to scroll down and see. I'm looking for something like super 70s vintage. This one. Right here. It looks very 70s. And then you can see there's a flower right here and other stuff. So I'm going to click on this. And let's try that flower, and then maybe the sun, and this. Let's see. I want that sun. Maybe not this flower. I don't know. We could try it. And then some leaves. And, oh, and these two things there. There. All right. So we got a bunch of graphics and a bunch of this. And I'm going to close this. So the first thing I'm going to do is play around with the graphics. I'm going to duplicate this page. Down here, I'll take out the words. It's still gonna be on my top one right there. So let's play around with the graphics here. Let's move this. The mushroom's the most important thing. So let's make sure that's big, nice and big. All right. Let's leave all this here. I'm gonna go up and move these guys. All right, so I want it vintage. I got the vintage graphics. Let's look for some vintage text. So let's go here and do vintage. See, what do we got? Oh, this Art Nouveau, I've used it before. Looks really cool, but I think I can type in Art Nouveau. There's a bunch of different ones. Yeah, so that was the letterpress one. I'm just gonna use it without the letterpress. Okay. And we want it all the way to the edge here. And maybe this one the same thing. So the Art Nouveau, right? Yeah. So I typed in retro to look for some script font and I found this one right here. It's called Genti. So I think that matches. We got some nice vintage script here. Kind of feels like the same era. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. Genti, turn this off, go back, Genti. All right. I have so mushroom in my heart for you. That should work. Let's bring the mushrooms and this in here. Put it here. Cool. That kind of fits. Let's move these up. Move this here. So we're just trying to fill that space now. All right, so I came up with this. I'm also gonna color this right here. So let's color these. Let's put a black background behind it. And of course, we're gonna have to change the color of the text to white. Or a light color. Let's put this in the back so we can get this one. Move this back to the front. Good, and I think this mushroom can be a different color. Let's do one of these lighter colors there. Kind of night. All right, I think this looks good on a black t-shirt, but I want to play around with the colors that Canva has. So let's duplicate this. You can see it right there. So I have this one and this one. We can get rid of this one now. So we have the two now, one with the black background and this one we're going to play with. So let's go to page two and then let's play with these colors, these styles. So you notice Canva recently used these different color palettes now. It looks a little different than it used to. It kind of has all the colors in a square with triangles. I'm going to see all here. And I'm going to try out some of these colors. Let's just play around with it. Oh, they're really funky. Oh, that's a cool one. That's a really cool one. Let's duplicate. Let's try different colors. So I'm just going to save the ones that I like. And just try out different colors. That one's funky. Whoa, that's pretty psychedelic. Yeah, that one. All right, so now that you've played with a bunch of colors, you look and see, do you like that one or that one or that one or that one? It's just a real quick way to get some ideas out. I like that one and I think this one is really cool. So whichever one you want, and you can, once you have those colors, you can still play around. You know, maybe you want that a little darker. So you want it, you know, like that. Just so you can see the face or whatever. So, yeah. So let's use this one and I'll show you what it looks like on a t-shirt. Oh, one of the cool things about doing Canva Pro now is I can knock out the background. So let's do that. I'm gonna share. I'm gonna download, I'm gonna do PNG, but transparent background, ta-da. And then you can go in here and select which one you want. Page four, let's do page four. We're gonna have to do, yeah, I think transparent background will work. So let's do done and download. So I also changed the colors on this one and I'm gonna download this one with a transparent background. Same thing. Download. I'm going to unselect all and just the first one, and transparent background, and download. So you can see both of them have transparent backgrounds now. Super simple with Canva Pro. I'm going to put this into Redbubble and let's see what it looks like on a t-shirt. So you can see the one I did on a light background turned out all right on like cream and on white. It would look okay. And maybe even this light gray might be okay. But when I start doing it on the dark colors, the text kind of gets lost, right? So if I wanted to do cream and those, that would be great. The other one that I did on a black t-shirt looks good on darker t-shirts. So this darker gray and the black and that. And I kind of like it on this one, which is the dark red. So a lot of these will work, army green and green. That one's kind of cool too. So I probably will pick this one just because it works better on dark t-shirts. And I'll show you the final product on a model. So here's a side-by-side comparison from before and after. You can see in this one, the image is too small. It's not really relating to mushrooms. You can't really see that that's a mushroom that they're holding. It's more of a pizza. I have the same words. I have so mushroom in my heart for you. I have so mushroom in my heart for you. This one is filling the space. It kind of has all of it works together, at least I think so. It's more of a vintage design. We have vintage fonts and vintage drawings, right? Mushrooms, big vintage mushrooms are in right now, so I kind of use that. And I'm filling this whole space right here, and then I'm working with the color. So here, they forgot to knock out the white. You can see that the white is here, but in Canva Pro, you can knock out that background really easily. So here's the before and after. So before, this is what we had. We had a pizza for some reason. I think this is supposed to be a mushroom, but you can hardly tell that that's a mushroom. And the pun is mushroom. So we wanna make sure that mushroom is the main thing here. Made it bigger. You can see it's the same model here. I used a black background instead of a white background. You could use a white one as well, but this one just stands out. The colors stand out better. And we're using that full size, that tall rectangle right here. And we're trying to fill in all the space and using more than just the mushroom. We're using lots of different things for interest and color to kind of give it a pop. I used the same color here, mushroom, as some of the colors here, because that's the pun, mushroom. So mushroom here. So I think it works really well. Of course, you could do it in lots of different ways, but basically use these tips. You know, if you're going to do vintage, then make everything vintage. If you're going to do a certain style, then try to make that whole style. It needs to all look like it's the same thing, right? That's kind of the idea. This whole composition is one thing. So keep that in mind when you're doing it. Make sure to try all the different colors as well. Some of those other colors looked good on white, but you could keep playing with it until the background is dark and then do that as well. So have fun with this. Hopefully these tips in Canva Pro are helping you out. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you and can show you some of the things now that I'm using Canva Pro. If you want to use Canva Pro, I have a link in the description for Canva Pro. Try it out for 30 days. That's what I'm doing. Seeing all the different features that may be helpful for you. That knock out the background feature is really nice, because if I had to go in there and kind of knock it out on all those different designs that I had in there, it would have took a long time. So that was a really nice feature. And you can see you didn't have to have the background knocked out. You can leave the background a certain color and it just knocks it out for you. So that's really nice. So if this video is really helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. Question of the day for this video is this: have you used mushrooms in your designs before? Mushrooms are really popular right now for vintage designs and cottagecore and all those kinds of things. Let me know if you've used mushrooms. There's so many mushrooms on Canva, and I just was looking at the free stuff. There's so many more with Pro as well if you have Pro. So let me know in that in the comments. And if you want to see more Canva tutorials, I have a bunch of them right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.